Hello everybody, Jet here, and welcome back to my Jade Blooded Vampires, Islanders of the Moon playthrough, where we are on a long pilgrimage north. We definitely didn't have to run away from where we started, because the pointy ears drove us out and were about to kill us utterly. Not at all, they started with a horrifically large force, so yeah. We have been slowly being pushed further and further away because they keep sending forces towards me. I think I'm going to try and head up north here and settle in the mountains to start with now. And then the plan is we will slowly make our way back and crush the pointy-eared gits. Take our home back, crush the pointy ears. So I do have a doggo asleep by my feet, so if you do hear the odd random noise, that's probably why, because he's got a bad habit of starting, he started to snore. Don't know if you can actually hear it, it's quite quiet at the moment, but... Where are the pointy ears? I know they were following me, it's whether they still are. Okay. Let's head up this way. And we'll start clearing this territory. And I might take the Eye of Tiger for the diamond mine, but I'm not in a rush to do that. We are a ravening vampire horde, which is passing peacefully through these guys' territory. These guys have done good by me. They are annoyed because I have been not raiding their territory, but I've been trespassing through their territory for a long time now, so they are understandably a little grumpy with me. Good, that the dwarves are right over there is good for me.
You dare approach a lord of the
good, no alliances, though they do a trade agreement with these guys, but that's not gonna stop me. Okay, and more hungry ghosts. But this is something we can work out once we get to the settlement. Can I actually get there? Don't want to start the war too early, daft as it sounds. If I start it too soon, they might well work out what my plan is. Come on! Stay away, dwarfy dwarfs. If the dwarfs are fighting the other pointy ears, other weird pointy ears over here. They're all pointy ears, guys. Doesn't matter. You know, there's no real difference between them, right? Right? Some point I am gonna... Somebody needs to make a sub-sub mod for these dwarves. Because they're cool. To war!
Doubtful.
So the dwarves have expanded quite a bit, but I'm not necessarily after all that territory. Yes. Oh, and that was the capital of the region, yeah. No, it wasn't. Growth. I want lightning strike. I guess I don't get to choose their school of magic.
I'll Alchemist of Shangyang.
Okay, so some interesting if they're owned things. Not my favorite tree, but I will try.
Secrets and potions. The House of Secrets permits it.
Ooh. Yes, for the vampiric corruption, though. Because I really want to kick that vampiric corruption to 6. To 100, to 200, to 6,000! I could just push for him to gather. I could push north to then tell me find the other guys. See, up here, if I can get up to here, I could have literally, I should have probably just gone for these guys because they are really, really defensible territory up there. You know, we could have just haunted the mountain, been happy, peaceful, haunting the mountains after killing the ogres. A little surprised the ogres and the dwarves have not fought yet. Yet, it's probably the key word there. Bugger. Alright, Groby Nutter. Can I actually recruit any? It's an interesting unit. Don't really want to swap anything at the moment. I'm going to swap some of them out. Ah, yeah. So I do have access to them. I'm going to hold here. I do want to do some recruitment, but we want to. I don't want to rush things. Because if I can get some of these units in, that'll be quite useful for me. And I can always fall back. I can always continue moving. Oh, shit. I mean, I'm glad I didn't attack, but that means I have to... I'm gonna get driven out again, guys. Damn it. This is a little depressing. I keep getting driven out of places. Nobody loves me, guys. Nobody loves me. They all hate me. These guys' melee attack is a bit crap. They still have the thing. So are they more closely related to the ghosts, I think? They are. They are a hungry ghost style unit. So actually, but they're hungry ghosts. They're a much more survivable hungry ghost style unit. So they're not really about their weapons, are they? They're about their debuffs again. That'll do. So, just much better versions of those. Much better hungry ghosts to use. I'm talking much better. They'll be much more survivable because they've got a really solid melee defense as well. Told you, I should have just gone past the dwarves and attacked the, attacked the ogres. I mean, technically, I could go around and still do that, but... I mean, why am I surprised? I'm getting them from the... Oh, no, I'm not getting them. I got them from attack, but I think... Gonna replace them with them. I say that. Yeah, I am. No, what's the speed on these guys? Better. There we go. I'm not sure I'm gonna keep hold of there, but we will see. I mean, I'm not even close enough to reinforce it at the moment, because I'm just worried I'm going to get pushed on again. We will spend our years in exile slowly building up our main army until we will come back max level. Really tough, you know. All this time surviving out of settlements for our ghosts, just making them tougher, guys. Tougher, stronger, leaner. They are clearly still worried by me. For melee defense, and then we'll go for even more melee defense. Can I get to them? This is very risky. I'm expecting to be pushed back, by the way, guys, with them both hitting me, because I did suspect that army was just back there. I think they were trying to cheese me a bit, trying to trick me out, which they kind of did. Because they bring both those forces, there's no, I doubt I can beat both of them. Interesting. Now that is interesting, because that means they are having to deal with other things.
Talk at me in your crude language if you must. I make no promises as to the outcome.
Interesting.
I am a rune lord, not some smith.
Plus, you know, they're potentially going to get rebellions because somebody's created an awful lot of corruption here. So potentially they're having to go back to their settlements to stop rebellions as well. And they take attrition whenever they move into out of their settlements at the moment. So the ambush stance is more about just staying hidden.
I have no time for this.
Age of Rage. Interesting. Not bad. But no, I am going straight for growth again.
In Nagaron, the strong thrive and the weak drown in blood.
I will. If they join my war, which they won't.
Me? Oh, don't mess with
I
me.
Will with them, though. Yeah. For now.
Black.
A bird.
Yeah.
I cannot extend.
They would actually potentially offer me peace. Interesting. Let's start working our way down here. That is spectacular. But no, that's going to be really solid for us because it allows me to get things quicker. Allows us to get more unlocks quicker. Replenish troops, to be fair, at the moment is far more useful for me. And allowing us to summon extra ghosts onto the battlefield. See, I would actually, daft as it sounds, I'd peace out with dwarves now. Because I want to go against the ogres. I would take a peace treaty with the dwarves for the time being. These mountains will be haunted, and anybody who leaves me alone for the time being is fine. Bollocks, I thought that was going to happen. It's fine, if I deal with the Krim Redbeard, we will be in a very solid position. And he doesn't have that great an army. Just need to get my horde growth high enough. Run away, Mr. Redbeard. You know you want to. My people have run enough. My ghostlings have run enough. Ha 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 ha. Yes, that end is definitely a. Ha! I said I would accept it if I was offered it, and I am a man of my word. I have accepted it. For now. You know, I've got the territory I want. They still have good territory there. Nice. Very nice. Interestingly, nothing seems to affect revenants, but I think it actually does. Oh, because there's still that type of unit. I get it. I did not even twig. We don't have a traditional... These are our walls. Okay, that's fine. Sorry, I'm R-ing at my doggo. He's being cute on the floor. Fortunately, the pup cam is not set up. And he's so big, he wouldn't fit on it anymore. Okay, I think it is safe to say it's time for my next war. The Death Toll clan will fall. Yes.
We'll kick you out, mate.
More growth. This one is really solid and defendable. This one's not so good, but it's a nice position to be in here. No, what about that old gutter fighter? Finally. A hanged doctor. Oof, single unit, but that is, yeah. Extra sanatorium staff, which gives me access to more of some really powerful units. Right, we're getting them straight out. They are far too useful for me. Really push the growth out, especially as we're on like turn 25, something like that, and we've not even started really expand. You know, we've only just got set up. It's been an interesting start of the campaign, but I'd almost peace out. I'm not going to, but if they offered it, I would seriously consider it. Now that's a bit worrisome because they could come around this way.
That's it! You're going in my gap!
Windshaper!
Let's hope that pressuring them will not make them, will stop them charging me. Right, I've not seen any armies. Let's go for here. Rip the ogres apart. I mean, we want to get to that. Himaranya is going to be next. And then we're basically just going to turn around and try and rip through them. I may even try and peace out with them so I've got access to an ogre camp. Because why not? Why the hell not? Keep them as my pet food. I'm a bit concerned where their armies are.
Only one I listen to is me.
Let's hit their capital, guys. Okay. Ooh, even more of them. Or I could do this. Death tunnels. I'm not sure how long that lasts for, or if it's permanent. But I think increasing my staff. Not necessarily going to use them, but... I think these guys are useful. It would be useful if I get a second arm. Basically, having the ability to get them is useful. And there are definitely other units I can get with that, so... Interesting choice of location to the border there. Oh, I see some ogres. I mean, we're doing the same thing in all of these settlements. We've got hardly any buildings we can actually build, so... Which does make them an easy faction to work out what you're doing with. These poor ogres. They are so stuffed. So Ind will fall to us, guys, and then we will reclaim our homeland, our islands. He came and looked and then ran away. Okay, they are a little chunkier than I expected. It's fine. Yeah, extra attack. Okay. We are finally beginning to get a decent foothold. We've got nearly got a couple of foothold regions now. We're building up. I'm probably at the point soon where I'll want to actually start rolling out a second army. Thank God we're a Horde faction. If I wasn't a Horde faction, I'd be dead. Oof. Oof. I think we actually have a fight, which I will fight next time. Sorry, guys. As always, thank you very much for watching. I do hope you are enjoying this playthrough. please do like and subscribe and pop a comment down below. And next time we will terrify Big Bellower Rough Beard Strangler. Anyway, guys, thank you for watching, and an extra special thank you to my channel members and patrons. That's Monsters Abound, Philip F, Nose Nose, Andrew T, Pritaru, Brandon, Space Ace 475, Coding Monster, Jason Air, Egg, Skrin, and Jared Horn. And thank you, everyone, for watching. Cheers all.